Welcome to the channel. In this video, we will see how we can set up Visual Studio Code so that we can write and execute C# programs in Windows 11 computer. In order to continue with this video, first you need to download and install latest version of .NET SDK in your computer, and then you need to download and install latest version of Visual Studio Code in your computer. If you don't know how to do that, then I have the tutorials. I will provide the link in the description box. You guys can watch those tutorials and set up the VS Code and .NET SDK. Now, before starting setting up VS Code, what we do is we will make sure that .NET has been installed properly. In order to check that, we will click on the start button and we will search for cmd. We will open up the command prompt, and here we will type in a command, .NET space minus minus info, and after that we will hit the enter button, and we can see the details about the .NET SDK that is installed in our computer. So if you get a message like this, then it means that you have done everything properly and you can set up the VS Code. So now we will see how we can set up the Visual Studio Code. So we will click on the start button, we will search for VS Code, and we will open up the Visual Studio Code. And the first thing that we do here is we will install some extensions that we need. So we will click on this extensions icon, and here we can search and install extensions. We will search for C#. What we do is we will install the extensions for C# developed by Microsoft. So here we can see C# development kit, C# basic language support, and then IntelliCode for C#, and all these three extensions are developed by Microsoft. So what we do is we will install these extensions. So I'm going to click on install on these extensions. And now these three extensions will be installed. Now the installation of these extensions will take some time. We will wait for them to finish. Okay, now as you guys can see, all these three extensions have installed. So now what we do is we will see how we can create a C# project and how we can run that. So here, the first thing that I want to do is I want to create a workspace for my C# projects. And for that, I will click on this file, and then I'm going to go to save workspace as, and here I'm going to save my workspace in the desktop, and here I will create a folder in my desktop. So right click, new folder, I will call it as C#, and then I'm going to open up this folder, and here I'm going to give a name for the workspace, C# workspace, and then we will click on save. So now after creating the workspace, what we do is we will add a folder to the workspace which will contain the projects that we are going to create. So I will click on this file, and then I will choose add folder to workspace, and again I'm going to go to the desktop or the place where I have saved my workspace, in my case inside the C# folder, and here I will create another folder, right click, new folder, and I will say projects, and then we will select this folder, and then we will click on this add. So now here we can see the workspace that we have created and the folder that we have created. So now we will select this projects folder that we have created, and then we will click on terminal and new terminal. If it asks whether you trust the authors of the files in the workspace, click on trust workspace and continue. So now what we do is we will create the projects. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a simple console application which will display hello world to the screen. In order to create that project, in this terminal we will type in .NET new and then console. So here we are saying we want to create a new project, and it is a console application, and then we can give a name for the project by using minus minus name, and then we will specify the name, which is hello world. So type in the command like this. You can give a different name for your project if you want, and then we will hit the enter button. Once this command is completed, in this projects folder, we can see that Hello World project has been created. So now what we do is we will click on this program.cs. Now here the C# extensions that we have installed will make sure that the project has all the necessary files needed. If any files are missing, then it will create those files and it will add them to the project. So now in this program.cs file, we can see a statement which displays Hello World to the screen. So now we will see how we can run this. In order to run this project, what we can do is, if you go to the top right corner, we can see this particular icon. If I take the cursor on that, it says debug project associated with this file. And then we have a down arrow here. If I click on that, we can see run project associated with this file. If we click on this, then in the terminal, this particular project will be built and it will run. So here we will wait. So now here the project is built and we can see the output of this program, which is Hello World. This is one way of running this program. Another way is we will go to terminal. We will click on new terminal. So here we are in the projects folder. Remember, our project is inside this Hello World. I misspelled Hello World. What we do is we will move into the Hello World project folder. So we will use cd Hello World. I misspelled Hello World. That's why, you know, I'm entering with that spelling mistake. And then we will hit the enter button. We are in the Hello World folder. So now what we can do is we can type in a command, .NET space run. And if we hit the enter button, this particular project will be built and it will run. And we can see the output of this program. So this is it, guys, for this video. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you guys face an issue while setting up the VS Code or while setting up the .NET SDK, then do let me know in the comment section. I'll try to help. So thank you for watching. I'll see you later in the next video.